She's bedded former prime ministers, entire sporting teams and even acting royalty. We're talking about the Windsor Hotel in Melbourne.
See where you, what you did there.
I didn't know where we were.
It's not only one of the most iconic buildings in the city, but it has a fascinating history and a long-standing tradition that is a must-do in the city. And we've sent our reporter, David Robertson, to tick off the Windsor Hotel from his Melbourne bucket list this morning. Oh, and he's dressed up in a suit. Hello there, Robbo.
Hello there, Sarah Harris, and a very good morning to everyone. That's right, we've actually put a Windsor knot for the Windsor Hotel. It's the attention to detail because I've got to tell you, a boy from Ipswich, Queensland, doesn't always expect to find himself in one of the grand hotels of not only Australia, but the world. So I'm very excited and I hope I don't mess it up. Now, it's here that so many people have called home for a couple of days or a little bit of time, and that is TV stars, movie stars, politicians, and of course, so many members of the royal family. There are 180 rooms here, including 20 suites. And we're going into the one that's called the Prince of Wales suite because yes, he has stayed here. It's a beautiful room. Five rooms are in this suite and it is absolutely luxurious. I feel nervous already just being in here. I'm worried about what I'm going to say, do or stain on the carpet because I'm that excited. Now, we've got a man here to help us out and that is, of course, David Perry, the CEO of the Windsor Hotel. David, good morning to you.
Bravo, welcome to the Windsor.
Oh, I'm very, very excited to be here. Now, what a wonderful history this place has and it really is somewhere that anyone who's visiting Melbourne should come and see.
Well, that's very kind. We're very proud of the Windsor. It's a great hotel. Mm-hmm. Staffed by the most amazing team you'll find in this industry.
Yeah, lovely. And it's all about hospitality, isn't it? Now, let's go and sit down because a big part of it is, of course, the afternoon tea. And I didn't know this, Sarah Harris, but the afternoon tea was actually, well, not invented, but approved by a royal.
The Queen herself, Queen Victoria. Wonderful times, Victorian times. And her friend, the Duchess of Bedford, it said, came up with this wonderful concept of an afternoon tea socialising between lunch and dinner. And as we opened in 1883, afternoon tea was served and it's been served ever since.
And that's 135 years for those playing at home, Sarah Harris, and 100 years before I was born in 1983. Did you think I was that young?
You look amazing.
Thank you so much. Right answer. They really do think of everything here at the Windsor Hotel. Now, the other people that have stayed here, we've got to go through the list. It is the who's who. It is Meryl Streep. It is Lauren Bacall, Laurence Olivier, Barry Humphries.
Muhammad Ali.
Muhammad Ali. Kylie Minogue.
Yes. Wonderful, wonderful. They bring such joy to the Windsor, as everyone does who walks in.
Even boys from Ipswich?
Especially boys
from Ipswich. Great, I'm glad. Now, we've got the afternoon tea here because there are actually rules that go with this. And, of course, we've got the scones here. The age-old question, and we're going to find out now because the Windsor would know the answer, is it cream or jam first?
Well, if I was being a diplomat, I'd say yes. And honestly, if you're a guest at the Windsor, please make yourself comfortable. Do whatever you like.
Yes.
But the way that it was started by Her Majesty, it was the jam first.
The jam first as well. Now, also milk and tea, there's a rule with that. If you want to be sophisticated, there's an order of things there, isn't there?
Well, there was a reason for it because back in Victorian times, the bone china was much finer than it is today. Mm-hmm. And if you poured boiling tea, into a bone china cup, it cracked.
Off it goes. So if
always the milk first.
And you'd hold it like that, would you?
Well, one is most welcome to hold the cup any way one would wish. But really, by the little handle
By the little handle. Milk first, milk tea first. Then. It really is a beautiful hotel that you've got here. Thank you so much for letting us crash here this morning. It is wonderful, Sarah Harrison. Certainly something you must do if you're coming to Melbourne. David, thank you very much.
It's been a pleasure. Everyone's welcome. 135 years to go. Come on down.
Come on down, David. Thank you very much. Sarah, a beautiful place here in Melbourne, the Windsor Hotel.
Robert, can you just quickly, I'm just dying to know, when you're holding a cup of tea, the pinky finger, does that need to be held up as well? Is that a thing?
Now, David, the pinky.
I'm sorry?
The pinky finger, sorry.
The pinky finger.
Yes, if we're holding the tea, pinky up or pinky down?
Well, I would just, depends really how you're feeling.
Yeah. Say I'm feeling excited to be here, would it be up?
That's a very good question. I think the pinky should be discreetly down.
That might be tough here because I'm very excited here, David, but discreetly down, I'll just push it down like that. But it's got a mind of its own, doesn't it?
Doesn't it always?
Hold on a minute, David, sorry. Sarah Harris, back to you, Sarah Harris.
That's right, discreetly down. Thank you very much, David Robertson. Well done.